Hello friends, welcome back my video lecture. In this video lecture we are going to study about the pH meter. Okay, the pH meter is one of the electronic device. With the help of that device we can measure the pH. Okay, so that instruments having the different requirement. Okay, it may be electrode and different knobs, okay, which require different conditions. So it is most sensitive electrode, which consists of thin membrane glass, which is responsive to the change to H plus, is used to measure the pH solution. Okay, so that pH meter is connected with the electrode, and that electrode we can dip into the solution. So that electrode is immediately responsive, it giving some readings. Okay, when we are deep into the solution, because in that solution the hydrogen ions are present. Okay, and that hydrogen ions, it will be count. Okay, and it will show the reading, it will show some digit. And which kind of pH meters are there? Okay, which type of pH meters are there? We can see, first of all, that is potentiometric or slide wire type. This is the first type of the pH meter. Okay, and the second is the direct reading type. So which having the two types of pH meter, first one and the second one. So we are going to see about the direct reading type. Okay, in this case some requirements are required for the pH meter. You can say they are the function, okay, should be always remember. Okay, without that we can't perform experiment by using the pH meter. So some knobs are there for that pH meter. Okay, some probes are there. What is the actual use for that knobs? So first of all we have to see the control knob, or we can say set buffer, standardization or calibration. So during the standardization, during the calibration of that pH meter, there are some giving a symmetric potential. We have to adjust that potential equally by using the control knob. That's why the control knob is there. Okay, it means if you will take simply buffer solutions, okay, in that you will dip that electrode and you will get some readings. That should be symmetric values. Okay, you can consider that is the symmetric potential. If it is not there, if it is not symmetric potential, then you can roll that knob, so you will get the correct symmetric potential. Okay, so this is the use for that pH meter. Now next is the temperature probe. So that is the totally depends on the glass electrode potential. Okay, for the giving pH values make it necessary to include the control. Okay, so that is the very important probe for that whole pH meter. Okay, and it should be room temperature is there. Okay, now next is the slope control knob is there. Okay, during the calibration that meter, during the calibration that meter should having the solution, that pH will be the 4. So for calibration of the pH meter we have to use that solution, the pH will be 4, that buffer solution will be pH 4. Okay, and after dipping that electrode, pH 4 solution, we have to roll that knob. Okay, and we have to see the reading. Okay, after dipping the electrode, and we have to check in the first buffer solution of pH 4, then it is assume the pH is standardized and will be give accurate reading for the all pH value in the range of pH from 4 to 9. Okay, in this way we have to calibrate it by using the slope control knob and by using different pH buffer solution during the calibration. Now what is the range for the calibration buffer solution? 4 to 9.2. okay, so that range buffer solution we can use for the calibration of the pH meter. Now next topic, that is combination of the pH electrode. Measurement of pH or hydrogen ion concentration for the pH instrument, we can connect that combination pH electrode, okay, and that is the glass electrode and Kalman electrode, which is made by these two electrodes are there, okay, glass electrode and Kalman electrode can be constructed together in a single probe, okay. So both electrodes are present at the one place and we call them a combination of pH electrode. We can say the combined electrode also and combination electrode also. So in this way, glass electrode plus Kalman electrode, we can say that combination electrode or combined electrode. You can see this is the diagram for the combined electrode, right? You will see here the filling hole cover, okay, and here at the center reference electrolyte filling hole is there, right, and at the below side here glass electrode is there, element pH, and here reference electrode is there, and here the reference electrolyte solution, okay, the glass pH electrode electrolyte is there, and last one is the here pH sensitive glass bulb is there, and reference junction. So electrolyte solution is there. What is the role of electrolyte? Which can conduct the easily current, whatever the we can giving current to that electrode, that current will easily pass from one place to the another place into this system. That's why the electrolyte we can filling into the electrode. Now we have to see the advantage of combination electrode. In the first one is the small volume sample also used for the measurements, okay. So the if we having very small amount of sample and we have to analyze the hydrogen ion concentration, so that time we can use the combination electrode, okay. It means the requirement of small amount of sample also is provided, okay. Next is the sample in limited access container, okay, and the next one is the it can be stored in pH 4 standard buffer with few drops of saturated KCl solutions, okay. So that combination electrode we can store into the pH 4 standard buffer solutions only, okay, and few drops of saturated KCl solution. These two solutions we can easily prepare and we can store well, okay, combination electrode. Next is the how we can make the standard buffer solutions and what is the use of standard buffer solution, okay, for the pH meter. We have known during the calibration we can use only buffer solution for the calibration or standardization of the pH meter, okay. So you can see to calibrate the electrode we need at least two solutions of the known pH, okay, and that should be which are they, 4.01 or 7 or 10, so that these three types of solution, buffer solution, should be required for the standardization of the pH meter, okay. At least we having the two solutions, 4 or 10 or 4 or 7, okay, as per requirement of the pH determination we have to take this type of solution. And you can say how we can prepare that standard buffer solutions, which solution we can use for the preparation of standard buffer solution. So preparation of standard buffer solution, we can take the mixing a weak acid, okay. If we want to prepare the standard buffer solution, so you will take weak acid plus conjugate base, or you can take also weak base plus conjugate acid. So both way we can prepare the standard buffer solution, okay. So acid buffer, phosphate buffer, etc. are used in the laboratory for the calibration of electrode and pH meter, okay. Now we have to see the application of the pH meter, where we can use this kind of pH meter. Okay, so first of all, we can see here to measure the pH of biological fluid such as blood. So forensic laboratory, okay, or in medical area, we can use the pH meter for the measurement of the pH, okay, of the biological fluid. It may be blood or plasma, okay, all these things we can consider, or urine. And second was the determination of the concentration of the substance. Okay, if we having the different sample, okay, so if we want to determine the concentration of that substance, so that we can use the pH meter there. Next is to know the pH of buffer solution. So how many hydrogen ions are present in the particular given sample, so that we want to know. So by using the pH meter, we can determine, we can identify. Okay, now next is to maintain the pH of reaction conditions. In some reactions, specific pH is required for that reaction to carry it out. Okay, so before going to proceed that reaction, we have to maintain the pH of that chemical reaction, okay, or surrounding conditions. So after that, you can proceed that reactions. Okay, so where we can use the pH meter. The next is to measure the pH of soil. Okay, in agriculture, we can measure the pH of that soil. Okay, and next is to measure the pH of rainwater also. Okay, and after that, we can say yes, it is acidic rain, or another way we can say that. Okay, the next is, it is used in a chemical laboratory or industry, food industry and the pharmaceutical industry. Okay, so different industries pH meter we can use. Next is, it is helps in analyzing the exact pH value of chemical substances, food grade product. We have no different food material we can eat. It may be biscuit, it may be Maggie. So different food materials are we can eat. So that food material should be a proper pH will be there. So that we have to measure with the help of pH meter that food material also.